progress. Them people, the whole building would be doing that if they could. What is up, my friends? Good morning. It is an absolutely beautiful Wednesday morning here in Arkansas. I just wanted to log in and let you know that I love you and I care about you and I'm thinking about you and that you are a badass. As evident that all the shit you've been through, here the fuck you are. I appreciate you for watching. I appreciate you for your discourse. I appreciate you for treating others kindly and doing things for them. Let's get right to it. Michael Flynn has just been sentenced. Robert Mueller recommends nothing, the minimum, since he's already put him through the fucking ringer. He's also saying Michael Flynn cooperated. He gave, 12 times he went and had meetings with them, anything they had questions on. Keep in mind, Michael Flynn worked for Donald Trump less than a month. Before that, he worked for Barack Obama. Now, he would have been a great national security advisor. In fact, he was. What he did was, and this is what he's pled guilty to, was something that there wasn't anything wrong with, except for his shit with Turkey. And he's working with Mueller to protect his son, because that's what Mueller went after, him and his child, in their dealings with Turkey. It's like $500,000 they took to do some kind of thing with Turkey and didn't even end up producing what they were paid for. But they did some kind of deal with Turkey. Now, that has nothing to do with Donald Trump at all. Or the campaign. What he did was give them the information he knew. What did he do? One of the things they got him for was setting up a back channel with some Russians. Well, the back channel, this is after he was elected the president, but before the inauguration. That's perfectly normal. To be talking to other governments, setting up back channels. Trump wanted to work with Putin. He wanted to make a friend of Russia. He wanted to help Russia come out of where the slump they're in so that we can all be a world power together. That's going to have to wait until people like Putin are gone. So, Flynn, there are 7 pages, most of which is redacted, talking about shit that he, you know, It really talks about other things. I doubt this has any bearing on Donald Trump whatsoever. Because as we know, there was no collusion with Russia. It did not happen. Okay. And we go to... what's his name? Oh, that damn lawyer. Oh, by the way, Michael Avenatti is not going to run for president. Big surprise, huh? Let's see. Michael Cohen. Michael Cohen come out. And he is in trouble. They indicted him. What he is saying is, well, he's not going to get in trouble. He wants no sentence as part of his plea deal. Really? This is... circumstantial. He doesn't have anything. He just lied to the FBI. He doesn't have anything on Trump as far as collusion either. Because as we know, there was no collusion. So, Michael Cohen has ended up a bust. Michael Flynn has ended up a bust. Paul Manafort is saying that they want him to lie on the president, and he's not going to do that. Jerome Corsi has said the same thing. There's a couple of other people who are doing that. Corsi actually sued the Attorney General, who actually sued Mueller, and is calling for the Attorney General to act on this and investigate it. So we'll see what happens there. That, I think, is politics. But we'll see. Because, you know, you can't... You can't be upset at a government prosecutor for being a government prosecutor. That's what they do. This is what prosecutors do. You have to change the law. You have to change the system. If you're going to have people whose job it is to lie to you, lie to everybody else, pull every dirty underhanded trick they possibly can to get someone else to lie about somebody if they can't find something. And that's what prosecutors do, especially special prosecutors. They've been talking about it all along. Mueller's going to squeeze these people and try and get them to compose if they don't have anything. That's his job. Impeach Donald Trump, you dummies. Impeaching for what? Hey, you know, I'm for that, actually. Maybe I'm a dummy too. But it seems to me that if you want to create another situation like what happened with Bill Clinton, where you know impeaching them is going to do absolutely nothing, because the Republicans are not going to jump on the bandwagon. Impeaching Donald Trump, that is not going to remove him from office. There is no possible way that's going to happen. It is absolutely a bunk deal. And in the process, you're going to spend a lot of political capital in doing that. You're going to piss a lot of motherfuckers off. All these people who've been screaming impeach, 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 when they realize that doesn't mean he's going to be thrown out of office. When they realize it means nothing, well, they're going to be a little bit pissed at the government that they've been talking about and talking to, and the fucking media that's been talking to them, because impeachment doesn't mean they're out of office. Bill Clinton was impeached in his first term. Don't forget that. You impeach and nothing happens and people realize it's all bunk and bullshit, Donald Trump's getting elected again. And you're going to lose the House again because you have Nancy Pelosi in charge. Old school. We don't need old school. Even the motherfuckers in the Democrats are saying old school's a bad idea. So much so they elected some idiot like Ocasio-Cortez. Telling you. Time to start thinking, my friends. All right. It's kind of cold. Carry an old jacket behind the seat of your truck. Give it to somebody when you see them cold. You hear me? Extra pair of socks. Stuff them in an old pair of shoes. Give them away the next time you see somebody who needs them. Especially if you're urban. That happens a lot. Be surprised how many people I saw asleep when it was snowing downtown Little Rock with no shoes on. See somebody who's hungry, feed them, especially if they got little ones around. Do what you can. McDonald's is right on the corner right over there. Buy them a cheeseburger. Be the bad motherfucker I know you are. Take care of each other. Be happy because you deserve it. I love you, sister. Have a good one. Oh, it is enchilada day, by the way. Go enjoy some enchiladas. Enchiladas to me are delicious, but in fact they are a mixture of what we all are here in America. We're a mixture of everything. We took a little bit of everything that's on that plate and made it ours. Enchiladas are American. At least what we get up here. All right, I love you. Have a good one.
Little doggy.